Hello friends, now India is a tax haven. Yes, you heard it right. Now India is one of the countries in the world where the corporate tax rate is as low as 15% on the total income. In this video, we are going to discuss what is the provision, what are the conditions, what are the tax rate, and how to avail this scheme. Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Tax Money. Indian government has recently introduced a special income tax scheme for domestic manufacturing companies, according to which tax rate of 15% is payable on the total income of the company. So after introduction of this reduced tax rates, India has become one of the countries in the world where the corporate tax rate is as low as 15% of the total income. The other countries in the world where the corporate tax rate is low is Singapore, where the corporate tax rate is 17%, and Mauritius, where the corporate tax rate is 15%. So this scheme was one of the initiatives for promoting the foreign investment in India. It incentivizes the Make in India concept, attract the foreign investors to set up their companies in India. So friends, now let us discuss what are the tax rates, what are the conditions, and how to avail this scheme. Section 115BAB of the Act was inserted into the Income Tax Act, which provides the reduced tax rate of 15%. Now we will discuss what are the tax rates under this section. There is a tax rate of 16.5% on the profits derived from manufacturing activities. In respect of short-term capital gain of listed equity shares and listed equity oriented units, there is a tax rate of 15% as per section 111A of the Act. In respect of long-term capital gain of listed equity shares and equity oriented, there is a tax rate of 10% under section 112A of the Act, exceeding income rupees 1 lakh. In respect of other long-term capital gains as computed under section 112 of the Act, there is a tax rate of 20%. In respect of any other income for which there is no specified tax rate under Chapter 12A of the Income Tax Act, that will be chargeable at the rate of 22% plus 10% mandatory surcharge. So effective rate would be 24.20%. Further, there will be no allowance of any expenditure or no deduction will be allowed from that income. Further, in respect of short-term capital gain on assets, capital assets, on which depreciation is not allowable, will be taxable at the rate of 22% plus 10% mandatory surcharge. So effective rate would be 24.20%. If the profit shown by the assessee company in its financial statements are more than the profit determined by the assessing officer following arm's length principle, in that case such excess would be chargeable at the rate of 30% plus 10% mandatory surcharge. So the effective rate would be 33% of the such excess amount. So these are the tax rates as mentioned under this section. So now let us discuss what are the conditions attached to this section. So what are the conditions I have to satisfy to avail the benefit of this section? First condition is the company should be registered or set up on or after 1st October 2019 and it shall commence its manufacturing activity before 31st March 2023. The next is the business should not be formed by splitting up or reconstruction of business already in existence, except a few instances as mentioned under section 33B of the Act. So while considering the term splitting up or reconstruction of business, certain parameters or issues have to be kept in mind. So what are those issues? First of all, the condition of splitting up or reconstruction has to be checked in the first year of operations. Next is, if the new setup of a company, manufacturing activity, is the expansion of business already in existence, shall not be considered as splitting up or a reconstruction of the business already in existence. Further, forward or backward integration of any manufacturing activity should not be regarded as splitting up or a reconstruction of business already in existence. The new business shall not be formed by transfer of major assets, employees, or customers. Further, both the units after the formation shall be independently viable commercial units. So they should not be dependent on each other. Further, old business should not be affected by setting up of a new business. Further, substantially the same person would not be doing the same business. If same person, substantially same person were doing the same business after the formation, that may amount to reconstruction of business. The next condition is regarding plant and machinery. Further, all the plant and machinery should be new, except 20%, there is a provision regarding if the old machinery is 20% of the total value of machinery. In that case, that would not be amounted as violation of any condition. Further, if any machinery was used outside India and the same is imported into India, and if the same was not used in India before its installation, and no depreciation on that machinery has been claimed under the income tax law while computing the income under this act, in that case, that machinery would be considered as new machinery and that will not be considered as violation of the this condition. Further, no building being hotel or convention center, in respect of which deduction under section 80ID of the act has been claimed, shall be used for manufacturing unit. Further, the new domestic company manufacturing unit should be engaged only in manufacturing activity. So if there are diversified business, there is also other business other than manufacturing company, then the benefit of this section would not be available. So one of the most important conditions under this section is regarding computation of total income. How the total income will be computed. So while computing total income under this section, no deduction in respect of under section 10AA, 32(1)(2A), that is additional depreciation, 32AD, 33AB, 33ABA, or sub clause 2 or sub clause 2A or sub clause 3 of section 1 subsection 1 or subsection 2AA or subsection 2AB of the section 35 shall not be claimed. Further, no deduction under section 35AD, 35CCC, 35CCD or under any provisions of chapter 6A under heading C shall be allowed. That is, no deduction will be allowed under these sections. Further, deduction under section 80JJAA is allowable while computing the total income. The total income shall be computed without allowing any set off of loss on unobserved depreciation under section 1072A of the Act. Further, that loss would be exhausted and no claim of the same will be allowed in future years. Further, additional depreciation under section 32(1)(2A) of that is also not allowable, and any brought forward unobserved depreciation will be adjusted against the written down value of the assets. Further, if the unit is in international financial service sector, that is IFSC, then deduction under section 80LA is also allowable. So if the conditions are not satisfied, what will happen? So company has two options, either to go for section 115BAA of the act, according to which tax is payable at the rate of 24.20% including 10% surcharge, no MAT applicability is also under that section. Further, the total income computation is similar to this section, or it may also move to normal provisions of that is either on the basis of turnover, that is if the turnover is below 400 crore then the tax rate is 25%, and if the turnover is above 400 crore then normal tax rate of 30% will be applicable. Further, what is the meaning of manufacturing? So manufacturing has been defined under this section. So manufacture or production of any article or thing, and research in relation to or distribution of such article or thing manufactured or produced by it, but does not include business of. So manufacturing is defined, but though these businesses does not include manufacturing. Manufacturing is not included these type of businesses. That is, development of computer software in any form or in any media, mining, conversion of marble blocks or similar item into slabs, bottling of gas into cylinders, printing of books or production of cinematographic films, or any other business as may be notified by the central government. Central government has the power to notify any business activity which would not be regarded as manufacturing. So what are the powers of the board under this section? The CBDT, Central Board of Direct Taxes, is empowered with the approval of central government to remove any difficulty or issue any order related to conditions of use of plant and machinery or hotel or convention center or scope of manufacturing as mentioned under this section. So under this section there is a provision regarding in which the power is given to the assessing officer. Somehow this condition dilutes the benefit of this or attractiveness of this section. However, the assessing officer is empowered under this section to calculate the profits of the company where, owing to close connection among the transacting parties, either due to any relation or shareholding or directorship, or for any other reason. For any other reason, the any other reason is very wide, so it may cover any possibility. Profits are more than expected in normal course of business. So in that case, the AO may determine profits according to him, and any amount of profit in excess of the profits determined by the assessing officer would be chargeable at the rate of 30% plus 10% surcharge. Now the assessing the assessee is also required to maintain documents and get the books of accounts audited under the transfer pricing regulation if the aggregate transaction between among those parties, among assessee and other parties, exceeds 20 crores in a financial year. The next provision is how to exercise the option, how to avail this scheme. So first of all, if you have once you have opted this scheme, you cannot withdraw. So if in any assessment year you have opted this scheme, you cannot withdraw later on. And the other thing, how to avail this scheme, how to avail the benefit of this scheme, the company, domestic company, eligible domestic company shall exercise this option before the due date of filing first year income tax return under section 139(1) by filing form 10B. So the form shall be filed before filing income tax return under section 139(1), that is before due date of filing income tax return, and the form should be, the option shall be exercised in the first year of company. That is, if the company is newly registered, then while filing its first year income tax return, they have to opt this scheme. So I have discussed what are the rates under this section, under this scheme, and what are the conditions and how to avail the benefit of this scheme. So this scheme was one of the important steps in attracting the foreign investment in India and let them set up their manufacturing units in India. Further, the government is also expected to bring more benefits and more incentives for foreign companies to set up their manufacturing units in India, especially after this COVID impact. So then recently PM has also announced that India should become a self-reliant, that is, dependency on the imports shall be reduced. So in this scenario, it is very important to incentivize foreign companies to set up their manufacturing units in India, so that all the products and all the intermediate products for a particular product are manufactured only in India. So friends, I think I have covered this topic and no important aspect is left. So I hope you like my video and please keep watching my videos and please subscribe to my YouTube channel Tax Money. Thank you.